Delegation of the Congress leadership has met with the CAG. This was the second meeting that we have had with the Comptroller and Auditor General. We have brought to the CAG's attention additional developments and revelations since the last time we had submitted the memorandum. Former French President, who is privy to the details and developments, François Hollande, has made the statement that it was not French government decision to keep HAL out or to select Reliance of Anil Ambani as the partner for Dassault, but this was the government of India, and the French government had no say in the matter. That confirms what we had said from the beginning, that it was only the Prime Minister, he alone, who was privy to the fact that he is going to take a decision or inform the French President that the earlier contract that was negotiated, the agreement between the two governments, was not going to be taken forward. HAL, which was to manufacture 108 aircraft, was to be excluded. The benefit of transfer of technology to the country through the HAL was to be declined, and a private entity which was never there in the negotiations was to be introduced. So that confirms one thing. Second is the dissent note by a senior official responsible for the acquisition procedures and processes in the Ministry of Defense, that is the JS Air, the Joint Secretary Air. Each of the three services have a joint secretary which coordinates and deals with matters pertaining to the Air Force, Army, and the Navy. So the JS Air dissent note is on record. Third important development has been the revelation, which contradicts the position taken by the government of India, or for that matter, the Indian private entity or Dassault. That is the statement made by Eric Trappier, the CEO of Dassault, 17 days before this new agreement was entered into and informed through the joint statement between our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and the French President François Hollande. Each and every detail and document must go through CAG's forensic audit before a report is submitted to the Parliament. We will insist for a joint parliamentary committee to take charge of all the documents which will come along with the CAG report, and then to fix accountability to those who have plundered public money and cheated the country.